Hey guys, welcome back. Bit of a mess today on the table, but yeah. Today, I'm going to show you how to install a 20 amp ESC similar to this, alongside with a hobbygrade receiver and transmitter. Obviously, you strip your rig back. Strip your rig back. Get out the stock ready to run electronics if you're upgrading a ready to run, or you'll be looking something like this. If you're struggling, I've seen people use M3 tape to secure this servo. I think the servo comes with a horn similar to this. You just screw it over the top, nice and secure. Your servo can be removed easily because I know that M3 tape is quite sticky. And there you got your servo in place. The first thing you need to do when upgrading is get a soldering iron and solder a JST cable like this to your motor, replacing the old one. Replacing the old one if you had a ready to run, or obviously adding this with your kit. If we take a look at the ESC, we've got a switch at the top. This is for brake on or off, not drag brake, but you've got like a forward brake and you've got like a pause then sort of thing before you accelerate again or reverse again. And then where it is now is off, so it does kind of have its own little drag brake depending on what gearbox you use. So if we take a look at the ESC, this connection is for this connection which meets the motor. So this one is for the motor. If we take a look at this one is for the battery. You've got your on-off switch for the ESC. And you've got where it connects to your receiver. So my receiver, I've got a 4-channel. Channel 1 is for your servo. Channel 2 is for your ESC. And then channel 3 and 4 for accessories like lights, etc., winches. 1 for turn, 2 for burn. Once you've got your cable soldered onto the motor, you'll be looking something like this, alongside with your servo, which is mounted with the spare horn. So now it's time to connect it all to the ESC and receiver. I'm going to show you guys some tips on where to put it. So channel 1 is turn. If we have a look, we've got a positive, negative, so I got pins up. Channel 2 is burn, as I like to call it. So we'll put ESC into channel 2. And that's it for your receiver. So you've got your servo, your ESC plugged into your receiver. Now a good little spot for your receiver in a WPL, I'm going to just place it there quickly to show you. Somewhere along the lines, or did you fill it perfectly? Somewhere along the lines of there would be a good place to situate your receiver and give you enough room to bring your antenna up into the interior of the vehicle or wherever you choose. I seem to have found an even nicer spot for the receiver. I've put the antenna under the servo horn. If you look how perfectly this fits, look at that. I think it was designed for it. Next, you need to plug your motor, which is this cable, and the newly soldered one. Plug that in. And last but not least, we need power. This is the battery. Now, if you're upgrading and you haven't got a battery, I recommend buying a battery with a JST cable to match that. Save you messing around. Or if you're like me, you had plenty of WPL batteries lying around, I took a JST cable, I got some connectors from online, JSTSM, and I made myself a custom battery wire to fit all WPL, MN batteries, etc. So plug that in. So we've got battery lead, motor lead, the receiver's all hooked up. Last thing to do now is get a battery and give it a test. So I've got my battery out. Another thing, when making a wire or connecting, double check the clarity is correct, they're matching up black to black, red to red, etc. Otherwise you could end up smoking your ESC. So got the power, turn it on, we got blue room, and that final jingle, if you don't get that jingle, it means your motor's not connected properly. But that final jingle, so now we've got, so straight away my steering is backwards, as you can see. So all I need to do there, steering, reverse. So now, oh, my steering was fine, I think. No. There we go. Yeah, so now my steering is fine. Let's try the trigger. Throttle's fine, no need to touch that. And there you have it. Hobby grade electronics installed. The next part, and the fun part, is making them fit. Always turn your rig off before your transmitter, because sometimes they can walk on their own. So what I'm doing now is just going to try and make it all fit nice underneath the servo tray. I kind of got a knack for this over the last year.
Okay. Turn it on and off, switch out. I'm going to see what the show do, roughly there. But yeah, see, I know this is a mess at the moment, guys. I'm just doing this to show y'all. Roughly got everything we want to go. On the power cable up there, on the motor cable there, on the on and off switch roughly here as well, over there. Get it all roughly where you want, like so.
Get your servo tray. And, yep, try and make it fit. Should fit. If you've placed it correctly, there should be enough room to line up with the holes and get your screws in. And there you have it. Got my battery cable. Got the motor connected with the new JST cable soldered on. Got the ESC plugged into the receiver. Got the servo plugged into the receiver. And we're now running hobbygrade electronics. In my opinion, it's the best upgrade you can make if you're converting a ready to rock, or if you, yeah, pretty much, yeah. If obviously if you've got a kit, you're already putting the electronics in, but if you're converting a ready to run, I wouldn't recommend going out getting a bigger motor or metal drive sash quite yet. I recommend getting yourself a 20 amp ESC, hobby grade receiver, transmitter of your choice. There's loads out there to choose from, and it makes these trucks a million times better. If you check back through my clips, this thing is, like I said, it's a stock little kit running the electronics I've just shown you, and yeah, it's very capable for what it is, because I use these between multiple rigs. I only count the price of the receiver, so I buy a new receiver. So this kit in total, including the ESC and the receiver and the kit, under £30, and it's a year old, super capable. So it's just a matter of mounting the body all back on, which is easy peasy, and yeah, you're ready to run. So before putting all this back together, I'm going to have a dab at giving it a bit of waterproofing. First thing I've done is remove the lights, use them in another rig, happy days. The second thing I've done, so I've prepared two rubber glove fingers. I've got some cable ties ready, and I've got some snips ready to cut the cable ties. So I'm gonna take everything that needs to go into the receiver. So channel one is turned, so that'll be the servo. Channel 1 in, second is channel 2, which is burn, which will be the ESC, and that's my setup, the receiver. Now I'm going to put it in a rubber glove. So I've used a little elastic band just to secure the antenna in place, so it'll fit inside the glove. Have a fun job of sliding the glove over now and getting everything in there. An antenna will want to move, but that elastic band is helping me out a bunch, stopping it from coming out where I want it. So I'm going to get this up as far as I can, so it gives me a lot more room to work my wires. So that's all you'll have. I'm going to try and, where's the antenna, situate this roughly there. Next thing we need to do is get a cable tight. To wrap it all the way around like this. Some shape or form. Your cable tie. Oh, I've lost my unwrapping there. I like to try and get a cable tie just above the connections like that. I don't know if you can see. Pull that nice and tight. We have one waterproofed receiver, repeat the process with the ESC. A little trick I'm going to go for, so the battery connector and the battery should be fine, the motor should be fine. Turn this on, I'm going to be turning this on, as you can see it's all flashing, battery connected. So the second I connect the battery, it'll be ready to run. And also, it'll stop my on-off switch getting wet. So again, like the antenna, I'm going to use a little elastic band to keep the on-off switch in place while I put the rubber glove over. Should help me a bit. It's not at the moment. Something like that to help me put the rubber glove over. It's trickier than it looks, this. Basically try and get all your ESC covered. Same process again. Wrap it up as tight as you can. Wrap the rubber around like this. Get your cable tight. I've been wanting to do this a while to my C14, so there's the ESC. Give it a pull nice and tight. Eye safety, always. PSC is the receiver. Motors are apparently fine underwater, from what I've heard, so there's no need to waterproof that. One thing I will be doing if I am going wading, I will be making little holes in the bottom of the gearbox so any water that does get in will be able to escape out. Super easy to do, remove the gearbox, drill or heat some holes in some shape or form, let the water out. And the battery connector's also apparently fine. If you wanted to, you could go ahead and waterproof that. This is just a basic waterproofing. Now the servo, I haven't done any kind of waterproofing to that, so I'm going to see how long that lasts. I have got a spare, what are they called? It's pretty much, you have to let me know in the comments, it's pretty much the little brain in the servo that, you know, you have to let me know what it's called, but I've got a spare one of those, so if that does get wet, I can replace that. Next thing to do is get it all in place, and get it tied down. So I've got some cables left over here, a little bit of length. My receiver there, as long as my battery wire's going out. Bit of excess servo cable, put that there. You could use elastic bands and tidy it up as well, so you're not piddling around with all this wiring. Just basically get it in line, and then get your servo cover, your servo tray. Wiggle it around until you find the fixings. I think I got a fix in there, let's have a check. Pop a screw in. If it bites, then you know you're in line. We've got no bite either side. Needs to come this way a bit then. See, there's a bit of a jiggle. You can't get it to fit. Like, that's a bite. And plug that in, just come straight on. There you have it. Super cheap and easy way to waterproof your rig. I will be looking into taking my servo apart in the future and maybe covering the electronics inside the servo with some sort of waterproofing, like grease or whatever, but we'll see how long the servo lasts and the gearbox. Happy crawling, guys.